have been looking into diagnostic sonography for a while. Ever since I started working, I've always had some sort of customer service job. So, and this is a lot of customer service. It's a lot of making sure your patients are comfortable, making sure they're happy. I've always loved imaging, so I figured this was kind of the best of both worlds. I get the technology side, and I also get to take pictures and help people.
I was an X-ray technician for 23 years here in Sacramento, and I was around all the ultrasound techs, and so I have always wanted to do that, but with children and getting them through school, it made it a little difficult. So now I've decided to go back into the ultrasound program, and the transition was pretty simple because I've already worked among, you know, in that atmosphere for so long.
Diagnostic medical sonography, we call it DMS, is a program most people relate to as being an ultrasound tech. That's not a term that the profession uses anymore. They call people who do this kind of work sonographers. It's a combination of acquiring a patient history, looking at all their lab values, all the things that the doctor has asked for, and then using the equipment to take pictures and document so that the physicians can make a diagnosis.
You know, you go in and you think it's all going to be babies, and it isn't. It's a lot of looking at livers and pancreas and kidneys and looking at your veins, looking at the arteries in the neck and things like that.
Good job.
It's Julie with her deep breath
and then makes all the shadows that are down.
I kind of dabbled a little bit, took one class at a time, trying to decide, is this something that I really want to commit myself to? And actually, after my very first prerequisite class, I was like, that's it. I'm in 100%. So I feel very lucky to have gotten to this program.
Right from day one, they got us right on the machine, so we learned how to actually use them with lifting, and they showed us all the buttonology. And now as we go into our sites actually have more advanced equipment than we have here, but the transition's been really good.
The very first day when we came to class, they said, we're gonna go scan. Get up, go in the back room, we're gonna go scan. And I think that was the greatest thing ever because it takes the fear away. And it gets you excited about it because you're excited, it's the first day of class, you're showing up, you really want to get to it, but you don't know that you're going to get right to it. So going back and seeing everything, being like, oh my gosh, that's what a liver looks like. It was very exciting.
Normally what we do is we demonstrate it, they practice it, and if they don't get it right the first time, they do it again. It really is a skill that's learned by practice.
We get volunteers every so often. They'll come in and we'll bring in friends and family just to practice. And just the fact the instructors have all of the background, all of them are still doing ultrasound. And that's pretty much the biggest help to all of us here.
Well, thank you so much for all of your patience. I've got perfect images for the doctor and I'm gonna send them through.
Once you're in the community, you start building your reputation during your internship in this program from day one. We have clinical affiliates with a lot of the large hospitals, teaching hospitals. They learn and glean as much as they can while being closely supervised by their credentialed sonographers.
Right now I'm at Davis, and I've been there for two rotations now, so about 6 months, and I'm enjoying it. And it's well prepared for emergency situations. I'm in the ER and also in the office setting.
I would definitely recommend this program to anybody who's interested in sonography. There are very limited schools out here. And there's, of course, with all the different types of patients we get to scan and the clinical hours that we acquire, it's definitely prepared us for a job in this market.